Oh, giant floating crystal ball, will you ever divulge to me your secrets of why you are here? And also why you make your sprites look so weird underneath you? Oh well, maybe your answers will come in another game. But for now, hello everyone, Gardeblaze here, and welcome back to another episode of Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone for the Game Boy Color. In the last episode, we pretty much found out that, well, fairly early on in the episode, we found out that, well, Snape seems to know how to get around Fluffy and potentially get around anything else that is guarding the Sorcerer's Stone, and Dumbledore has left for London, called by the Ministry of Magic down there, which means that the only one that Voldemort fears is not in the castle. Which means we now must go and defend the Sorcerer's Stone from the evil Severus Snape and Voldemort. But yeah, after that we pretty much spent the entire episode level grinding. It was kind of a short episode since I cut most of it out. But now, we are going to go to Gryffindor here. And just a quick reminder again, once you go in Gryffindor, this is the point of no return. Go in here, it will become night, and you will have no option but to go to the third floor corridor and start the run up to the final boss. And so, if you still feel like you need to go and level up, for anyone who's watching along with me, do so now. Anyways, I feel like I am ready, so let's go in. Pig snout. In you go, dear. As soon as you go in, you don't even get to enter Gryffindor. Professor McGonagall says that Dumbledore is in London. If she knows Dumbledore is gone, so does Snape. He'll go for the stone tonight. Then we'll all have to get to the stone first. Not without me. Nor me. It's time. Better put on the cloak and... Oh, hey, Neville. Trevor, are you down here? Hey, what are you doing? Nothing, Neville. You're not going out again, are you? No, we're not. Go back to bed, Neville. You can't go out. You'll get caught again, and you'll lose more points. You don't understand, Neville. This is important. I won't let you do it. I've learned how to stand up to people from you. I'll fight you. I'm sorry I have to do this, Neville. Petrificus totalitus. Petrificus. I botched that, sorry. Poor Neville. Petrificus totalis, I think that was. Still, my apologies. You'll understand later, Neville. Poor Neville. He was about to fight us, like he was ready to go in for a boss fight, but nope. He just gets left here on the floor. Anyways, we are heading out now. The fat lady is gone, so we can't go back into Gryffindor. And our option is to... Sorry, our quest is to go to the Forbidden Corridor. So here we go. There are magical encounters out here, of course, so try your best to avoid them. If you do not, well, just immediately flee. You're going to need to conserve your health. And as soon as I say that... And they go first. Darn it! Stupid spiders. Because remember, the hospital ring is not available now. It is locked. You're under the invisibility cloak. So these magical encounters are going to serve as nothing more than a hindrance. Fifth floor hallway here. All they're going to do is just hurt you and make you suffer. Anyways, one more floor to go. There is, sadly, I wish this happened in the games. It didn't happen in the movie. It only happened in the books. But there was a... wishful thinking. There was a point in the book where on the way down to the third floor, they run into Peeves, who is putting up the carpeting on one of the staircases. And Peeves doesn't see them under the invisibility cloak, obviously, but he senses them, like heals them. So he demands to know who's there, or else they'll go and be ratted out by Peeves. And Harry, somehow, despite only being 11, manages to mimic the voice of the Bloody Baron, telling Peeves that the Bloody Baron has reasons for being invisible, and to go off to another section of the castle for the time being and leave the Bloody Baron alone. And Peeves, fearing the Bloody Baron, flees that area of the castle immediately. So that's just something cool that Harry did that I like. Wish it was in this game in the movie, but, well, we all know Peeves was cut very early on from the first movie and never made it into any of the other ones. Such a shame, such a shame. Anyways, here we go. It's a jar. Snape must already be in. Here we go. The three-headed dog, Fluffy. I don't think he can see us, obviously. Quick, Harry, start playing the flutes. And that flute that Hagrid gave us back in Christmas comes in handy. He's asleep. Let's go. I don't think they ever used it again for the entire series after that, though. Anyways, we're down in the trapdoor. We've landed on some... Well, we've landed on cobblestone. Well, Hermione, you seem to have this nice plant to cushion your fall, though. Except it's very much not a nice plant to fall on. These plants are wrapped around us. They must be devil's snail. I've read about them. Use light or fire, Harry. And here we go. First boss, the devil's snail. Middle one missed. Anyways, yes, we have three pieces of the devil's snail that we have to take care of. We have the middle one, which is the main boss, and then two smaller finds off to the sides here. I'm going to use Locomotor Ribley on the center one while I pick off the outer two. Since the outer two barely do anything, but they're just nuisances. Okay, as Hermione said, you need to use light or fire. You can use Formilius, since it is a sparkly light spell, but I do believe the better option is just to go and use Incendio and burn the plant to death in this case. As you can see, you can easily take out the fines there. Incendio duo. Unfortunately, Ron doesn't get his cool moment from the books, nor Hermione her cool moment from the movies, but, well, unfortunately, those are skipped over in favor of Harry just having to fight the devil snail as a boss. Okay, let's use mucus ad nauseam and poison a plant here. Before we go and use Incendio duo on the devil snail itself. 165 damage. What? What? Oh. So, I may have, in my fear of the strength and power of the final boss, potentially over-leveled myself? Because the final boss does have a difficulty spike, and there's generally a difficulty spike when you enter here, which is why I leveled up. And yes, magical encounters are now spawning since the devil snail is gone, but I've never... destroy the devil's snail like that. I may have overleveled out of fear of the final boss and wanting to not go and have a fantastic time on the let's play. Whoops, sorry guys. I guess level 50 might be a tad bit overdoing it. Also, current quest is kind of spoiling the next thing we need to do. How much damage do I even have? Not much damage at all. The main plant missed with its one attack. I do need a few pepper potions, though. Use a couple of those. And I should be good. Yeah, I'm good. Okay. Anyways, continue on through this giant mass of plants. It goes way over here. Wow, this is a huge room, especially since you don't need to go all that way over. I'm curious, what does appeal down here? The rats, seriously? That's it? Okay. Ready, rat? We're gonna do this? Thank you. Okay, well, no need to really level grind down here. Here we go to the next one. Birds! Thousands of them! They'll probably attack us if we cross the room. Those aren't birds. The winged keys. Well, anyways, if we do cross the room, well, nothing happens. Simple as that. But if we get to the store, locked. One of those keys must open it. But which one? That key near the fairy top is different than all the others. Mean that gold one with the silver keys flying around it? Gold definitely stands out from silver. That's the one. Maybe it opens the door. You should fly up and get it, or we'll never get through this door. But I don't have my broom. Yeah, we never really got the Nimbus 2000 in this game. Whoops. Take mine. It's only a beginner's broom, but we don't have any choice. Thank you, Ron, for conveniently having a Comet 260 on you. It's not the best of brooms, but it'll do. For now, at least. Anyways, unlike the other games, the other flying games, this one is more of a square area. And instead of going right, instead of going toward the right from the left, it is instead trying to go up with all these keys stopping you and just trying to, ow, get over to the side here. There's the main key we need if we can get up there. No, stop, please, keys. What did I ever do to you to deserve this? Ow. There we go. I have the key. Let's go. Alright. Welp. That was a bit of a short episode, but I have plans to go and divide this area up into three segments anyways, because the next segment is more bosses. In plural. In just the next room. And even if I may end up accidentally one-hit KOing all of them, well, it might be a bit harder because I honestly don't remember what the weaknesses of the next bosses are. But yes, I'm sorry I may have overleveled a tad bit. Hopefully the remaining fights won't be that ridiculously easy. But for now, this is Gotta Blaze, and I will see you next time. So long, everyone.